Today we can start with the fourth module. In the fourth module, all of you can take the second poem, that is on Killing a Tree. And when we go through the second paragraph about the author, you can see what is the theme of the general theme of the lesson. And there, as you have seen in the first part of the second paragraph, basically the poet is talking about killing a tree or cutting a tree. And as you go through the second paragraph, the description says it is not basically talking about cutting down a tree. On the surface it is cutting down a tree, but it is actually written as a satire and a protest against humans' attempt to overcome nature. And we may think that through our human actions we can overcome nature, but the poet is trying to say that even though we are trying to destroy nature, nature has the power to regenerate or coming back to life. And that idea is proving through the poem on killing a tree. And even though our actions are destroying nature, nature can come back to life without our help. So for example, when we think about a forest fire, even though we are not helping the forest, after a few years we can see the forest is coming back to life. So such a regenerative power of nature is proved through the lesson on killing a tree. And when you go through the lesson, you can go to the lesson poem on killing a tree. And when you come to the first part of the lesson, you can see some important terms are used by the poet. And first of all, when we come to the first line of the poem, and there you can see a word, kill a tree, is used by the poet. And that kill a tree, that word is very important in the lesson, because the poet is not talking about cutting down a tree but killing a tree. That involves a complete destruction of a tree. So in order to prove that, the poet is talking about the term kill a tree. And then in the second line onwards, the poet is talking about what are the several procedures the humans are doing in order to kill a tree. So first of all, the poet is talking about the word jab of the knife. Jab means using a sharp point of the knife. Sometimes we make a small point or wound upon the bark of a tree. And when we make such a point or poke on the bark of a tree, we may think it can kill a tree. But it is unable to kill a tree like that. Because the reason you can see in the third line onwards, it is not an easy task. We humans may think that kill a tree is very easy, but it is not at all easy. Because the reason the poet is talking in the third line onwards, that you can see when you take your lesson, you can see that jab of the knife is not able, or a mere poke on the trunk won't kill a tree. And from the third line till the ninth line, we can see the poet is explaining the reason. And so the third line says, because the tree is becoming a tree, not merely, it is after so many years of consumption of earth. The poet is talking like that. Consumption or consuming the earth means it has a wide root system. So when a small sapling is growing into a tree, and it has a wide root system, after so many years a wide root system will be there, and that root system is supporting this tree. So whatever nutrients, minerals, water, sunlight a tree needs, and it will be taken by a tree by this wide root system. So this wide root system is supporting the tree for so many years. And so such a tree, when we humans are trying to kill such a huge tree, it is not very easy as we are thinking. And that is what the poet is telling from the third line till the ninth line. The reason is clearly given there. And then you can see in between, that is third and ninth line, you can see about a word, leprous hide. And then the poet is talking about the sprouting leaves, etc. And then, so there the poet is talking about that word, leprous hide. So the word leprosyde is very important in the womb. It refers to the outside skin of a tree. The bark of the tree is called as leprosyde, and it is described as leprosyde because from this portion of the tree, small branches are coming out. And later, these small branches will be formed into big branches of a tree. And it forms several parts from the main trunk. So this leprosyde, that portion of the tree is very important. And from there, so many branches will be coming. So suppose we are cutting down a tree, simply cutting down. And when we cut down a tree simply, and after so many years, small miniature boughs will be coming, small leaves will be coming, and when we are not doing anything, after a few years, another tree will be coming in place of that. And that is what you can see in the first half of the poem. And so there, the words like miniature bough, then bleeding bark, the poet is talking about a word, bleeding bark in between. The bleeding bark also refer to another important thing. For example, when we have any wound upon our body, even though no medicines are applied, it will be healed completely. Similarly, and using a knife, when we make a wound upon the bark of a tree, it will be healed completely. That also shows the word, the line, bleeding bark will heal, also refers to the regenerative power of nature, or nature has the power to heal its wounds. It has it such a power. It shows that. And then, as we have seen already, miniature bow refer to the small size of the branches. And if we are not doing anything, this miniature bow will be coming back to another tree, or it will be again the former size of the tree. And that is what we have seen in the first half of the lesson. And that means from the beginning till this first half, the end of the first half, the poet is generally talking about the regenerative power of nature. And then he is talking about killing a tree. And killing a tree is not very easy. And what is the reason the poet is talking? The main reason is a small sapling is growing into a big tree after consuming earth. That is, sunlight, air, water, etc. will be provided to the tree by the wide root system formed after so many years. And so because of that, and even though we humans are thinking that killing a tree is very easy, it is not at all easy. That is what the writer or the poet is proving through the first half of the lesson, in order to prove that he is talking about the main part of the tree, like leprosyde, and then sprouting leaves, etc., and then about the regenerative power of nature. And also towards the end of the first half of the poem, the poet is talking about the tree is coming back to life once again. And when we come to the second half of the poem, there the poet is once again talking about what are the different steps involved in killing a tree, and that is given in the second half. In order to kill a tree, it need a lot of steps according to the poet. Some terms are used by the poet here. And first of all, he talks about pulling out something, and here pulled out here refer to the root system should be pulled out. And when we come to the second line, here the poet is using a term, anchoring earth. And all of us know a ship is using an anchor. And we know when a ship is using an anchor, and it will be firmly holding upon the deepest portion of the ocean. So similarly, this root system is helping the tree, and anchoring earth here referred to, earth is described as an anchor because earth always gives support. So like sunlight, air, water, etc. are going to the branch of a tree through this root system. So this root system is supported by the mother earth. So the earth is supporting the tree like this. So it is acting like an anchor, like the anchor of a ship. So the tree is always stable upon the earth because of the action of this earth or the support given by the earth. And then the poet is talking about another word that is roping, tying, etc. The poet is using. Then snapping, that means when we think about killing a tree, we have to do so many things. First, we have to pull out a root system from the earth, from the mother earth, and then using a rope, we have to tie it. And when it is hard, and we have to snap it, and then only